It came from the combination of a landscape and a feeling I once had. There was a time when my family drove far out into the mountains, and I live in the mountains, but we went to different mountains to get this firewood. And we drove so far out into the middle of nowhere, and I remembered going up this road and thinking, how will we ever find our way back down? And then when we arrived at the clearing where there was firewood that was, it had already been cut, and we were just going to load it onto our truck, the moment I stepped out of the truck, I was overcome with this intense feeling of grief. And it was a mix of grief and fear, kind of. It was a strange dread, but it was a dread about something that had already happened. And I had the sense that this place had a memory, and I didn't know what the memory was, but I just felt it rising from the ground. And it had nothing to do with the landscape itself, because it was very beautiful. You know, it was a very beautiful place, but the feeling that I had was so sinister, and I felt I needed to discover what the memory of this place was, and that was the process of writing the novel. The plot is, at the heart of the story is a terrible tragedy about a little girl who is killed, but that happens 8 years before the novel opens. And so when it opens, it's about a new wife who has married the man who has lost his daughter, and it's about how they endure in the wake of this tragedy that happened years before they got together. And so it's about this new wife trying to understand his past. And in that way, it's a love story, because in marrying him, she's married his past and his tragedy. And as he's slowly forgetting these memories because of early onset Alzheimer's disease, she feels it's her duty to remember for him. And that's very complicated, because she can't remember, because she wasn't there, and because he doesn't talk about what happened very much. So she's trying to, as respectfully as she can, discover what it was that happened. And so in doing so, she forms this strange sort of sisterhood with his ex-wife, whom she doesn't speak to, but she feels this kinship to, even though his wife is serving a life sentence in prison. Idaho is a place I love dearly. It is my home, but it's a very complicated place. It's a combination of extraordinary natural beauty and also dark secrets. And where I lived, I felt that I could walk through the mountains, and you know, there's flowers and there's animals and just lovely wilderness. But you never knew what you would stumble upon that was sinister, you know. And there were very scary things that I found deep in those woods, and things I often didn't understand, a lot of violence, you know, in the animal world and in the human world. And my childhood was wonderful. I had a very, very happy childhood, loving parents, loving siblings. But we were surrounded on this mountain by these unseen strangers that were our neighbors, you know, distant neighbors, because everybody owned a lot of land and it was very secret. And a lot of them were quite hostile. I was obsessed with a lot of things, and one of them is the question of, if you do something terrible, like if you're a good person your whole life, and then you have a lapse of self and you do something terrible, who are you after that moment? Are you still the same person that, you know, did all these other things, and you know, what happens to you? And I've always, my whole life, I've thought about prison since I was a little girl. It was a deep fear that I had that I would one day go to prison, and I would think from a very early age, how will I still be Emily if I'm in prison? And so that was one of my obsessions, is just how a woman in particular, who's done something terrible, but how she might still have a sense of self even if she's trapped within these four walls, and how to hold on to your dignity and your you know, your soul, for lack of a better word. And you know, so I'm also obsessed with even, you know, the novel leaves a lot of questions that are unanswered. We don't know where the missing child is, and we don't know exactly what happened in those moments when this murder was committed. And I think that that's how most of the mysteries in our lives are. I think when somebody loses somebody else, somebody that they love, to a tragedy like this, to just something so unfair and horrible, that there never is an answer, even if there is an answer. And so I was obsessed with how to go on, even if you don't understand, you know, how to live with not having an answer. Those are the things that carried me through the whole story.
Est-ce que c'est un roman qui commence d'abord avec tes personnages ou d'abord avec le paysage? Ils sont tellement mêlés l'un et l'autre que j'ai du mal à départager, parce que vraiment ces personnages sont ancrés dans cette terre montagneuse. Et pour moi, j'ai des couleurs, en fait, quand je pense au début d'Idaho. Et ces couleurs-là, je les associe au personnage autant qu'au paysage. J'aurais beaucoup de mal à le décrire, son style, parce que elle a vraiment... Parce que c'est un style qui lui est vraiment propre, comme là, c'est la marque de tous les grands écrivains. Et puis parce que c'est une musique dans laquelle j'ai essayé de me fondre, moi, en tant que traducteur. Et donc, je n'ai pas eu de recul sur ce analytique, sur cette musique qu'elle propose, mais je sais que justement, voilà, elle tisse tous les éléments sensoriels et intellectuels, le passé, le présent, dans la même maille. Donc pour moi, c'est quelque chose qui c'est comme une espèce de rivière qui coule et qui emporte tous ces éléments, et avec un peu de chance, emporte le lecteur avec. Les signes particuliers de l'écriture d'Émilie, pour moi, j'allais dire le mot beauté tout simplement, ce qui est un peu très très vague, j'en conviens, mais c'est ça, c'est la manière dont j'en reviens toujours à la nature et à ce qu'elle a de mystérieux. C'est le mystère aussi, le mystère qui est ancré dans la terre et qui est ancré dans les personnages, dans la vie des personnages, dans leurs relations entre eux, dans le passé, dans le présent. Donc pour moi, c'est une écriture qui investit complètement le mystère. Alors souvent, on parle de parti pris de traduction. Vous me posez la question, quels ont été mes partis pris? Et donc, moi-même, quand j'apprenais la traduction, on disait qu'il faut prendre des partis pris de traduction. Alors moi, je ne suis pas sûr d'en prendre, en fait. Je me laisse vraiment imprégner par l'écriture. Et ensuite, j'essaye de suivre Émilie là où elle va. Et grâce à la personne qui travaille après avec moi, qui relie ma traduction aux éditions Gallmeister, on teste ce qui fonctionne ou non. Là où je suis allé trop loin, pas assez loin, là où j'ai pu garder, rendre cette poésie, tout en faisant en sorte que ce ne soit pas trop obscur. Voilà, parce qu'il faut laisser le mystère, mais pas en même temps être dans l'obscurité. Et c'est ça tout le défi auquel je me suis attaché. Voilà.